I'm Terry, and this is the Yarn Joy Podcast, episode number 152. Welcome. Okay, so I have three finished objects today and just one works in progress that I worked on, but I have three finished objects, so let's see what I've got done. Okay, so for my first finished object, I finished the preemie hat. This is preemie hat number one for the month of May to go along with the Halloween hat drive that I donate to for my one of my local hospitals, their NICU department for their preemies. And so this is a little tiger hat that I made, and I did stitch some stripes there on his face, on the side of his cheeks and on top of his head a little bit. I think that top one's kind of wonky, kind of crooked. Anyway, now this is actually was a set of doll hats, a pattern that I found. It had several ones, and the tiger was one of the ones, the options you could do. This is a pattern by Joanne Jordan, and I will link it in the description box below. But like I said, they are for some crocheted dolls, like costumes, but I was thinking that they would be perfect size for a small preemie, and so I went ahead and tried the pattern out, and I'm real happy with the way it turned out. I think it turned out really cute. So that is finished object number one, and this is preemie hat number one for the month of May. Okay, and now the next one, I saw this pattern. It's a YouTube tutorial by DIY-100ideas, and she had this tutorial, and I thought it was so cute, and I happened to have some yarn that would go well with it that wasn't planned for anything to be used. And so I just started making him, and I just could not stop until I was finished, and so I finished the whole thing. But this is a crocheted llama or alpaca, I guess you llama, right? But anyway, I think he turned out really cute, and I made it with Bernat blanket yarn. Okay, in the pattern she also, I believe, had a like a neckerchief or some type of thing hanging from his neck, but the pattern for that was not included in the tutorial, and so I just made the llama. Now she did it where she used gray. I didn't have gray. I had this I don't have the ball band, but it's over there. It's like a taupe or something like that, I think. And then she did white for the feet instead of this. I had this dark brown that's not blanket yarn, but it was some chunky yarn. And so I just used that for his feet. And then I used the white for his head, just like she did. But anyway, I think he turned out really cute. I used 15 millimeter eyes, which is safety eyes, which I believe that's what it called for. But it just seemed like his eyes are kind of big, but maybe not. The feet are done, you know, the four, they're separate, and then you connect them together and continue on with the body. And it's really interesting how you close off the top here and leave part of it open and you continue on. So it's basically one piece. You did have to do the tail is separate, the muzzle is separate, and the two ears are separate that you have to sew on, but that's it. And so I really like the way it turned out. I think he's really cute. Okay, and I really love the texture that this blanket yarn made. It's just single crochets, but it made a great texture, I think. I don't use blanket yarn very often. I think this might be the second project that I've ever done with blanket yarn. And so I'm really impressed with how it turned out. Okay, so for my third finished object, this goes along with two different crochet challenges that I've been participating in every month. This qualifies for the Happy Scrappy Yarn Challenge, and it also qualifies for the Stash Buster 2020 Challenge. This is a crocheted brooch that I made. Let's see if I can see. It's, there you go. See? This is made out of crochet thread, the number 10, like the doily thread, and I believed I used a number 7 steel crochet hook. And then this button right there, it's something I had for a long time. I just picked it up, I don't even remember where I picked it up at, but I just thought it was pretty. I liked the sparkle to it, and I love that color of stone. I know it's fake, but anyway, I love that color. And so I had it for the longest time. I never put it on anything, and so I was getting my button box out to try to find a center for my flower, and that I thought looked the best with it, so that's what I went with. Anyway, so the way it qualifies for both of the challenges is the fact that the Happy Scrappy Yarn Challenge for this month is to make some jewelry that is crocheted, and so like I said, this is a brooch, see? And then, so that's how that qualifies. And then also it qualifies for the Stash Buster 2020 Crochet Along, because in that one, Ella of No Catchy Name is hosting it this month. And her challenge for this month is to, besides use stuff that's in your stash already, the yarn or thread or whatever you have, also to work from a book that you have. And I'm trying. Okay, so the book that came out of is this book right here, is 150 Weekend Crochet Projects. So that's where I got the pattern. So it was a book that I had already in my crochet library, and so I'm looking, there it is. This is right there what it looked like. Yep. And so it worked up really fast. Didn't have any problems with it. You know, you are using a very small hook, and so some people may not like to do that with the crochet thread, but it wasn't too terrible bad. You just kind of take your time with it and don't hold your tension so tight that it cuts off the circulation in your fingers. But you know, I didn't mind it. And so that is my finished object number 3, which will qualify for both of those challenges for the month. So that's awesome. Okay, so that's my finished object. So my works in progress, I've only got one of the thing that I've worked on. Well, I've got a couple that I'll tell you about, but I won't show you. And then I have one that I worked on that I can show you. And it is the preemie hat number 2 that I'm going to be doing for this month. And I just started it, so I don't have it very far. But it is going to be, I don't have the eyes stitched on, but we'll see if they won't fall off. Let's see. It also has some purple antennas. Anyway, whoop, there goes I. The nose is stitched on. But anyway, this is the Hungry Caterpillar baby hat. Now, it was a baby hat pattern, and I used, instead of worsted weight yarn, I used some sport weight yarn in this red color. I believe it's I Love This Yarn Sport Weight, and I've had it forever. And then I used mandala, pieces of mandala cakes in the colors that I needed for the other parts. And so anyway, and then I used an F hook. So I went down from what the newborn size was for the pattern. But the pattern is from handmedownhobby.blogspot.com, and I'll put a link below. It is based on the children's book, The Hungry, Very Hungry Caterpillar, I think it's called. My kids are grown, and so I don't even remember that book when my youngest was real little. So I'm not sure. I'm sure other people that have younger kids would recognize the storybook. But anyway, like I said, see, so he's got the eyes there, the two eyes, and then they're kind of purple-looking antenna that I need to crochet and stick on the top, and then he'll be done. So I thought it was gonna. It's a cute little project, and it's worked up real quick. And so I'm sure those that recognize the storybook will enjoy it. Oh, you know what I'll do? I will find a picture of the book and put it up here, so that way you can see what this is supposed to be looking like. So So that's all my finished objects that I've worked on. I'm still working on the Lost in Time shawl, but I have not done any work on it. And then, of course, I've got the baby blanket in that gray color. I did a tutorial that I just recently put up a few days ago. If you haven't seen it on my channel, where I was showing how I did that blanket that I'm working on. It's just a pattern that I just kind of worked up as I was going along. And so I'm still working on that. Haven't really done much on it since I showed it to you last. So that's it. Oh, and then I'm working on my Whipwall Wednesday project. I'm still working on that, and I will be doing a video next Wednesday for the next episode, and I will show in detail what I'm doing on that and my progress on it. So I'll save it for that. But I'm working on it. And then also I am working on the summer banner pattern design, like this one that I did for spring. I finished one of the three panels, so I'm about to start the second one. So I will save that to show you when I get it all finished and put together. But I did finish one of those sections. Okay, and then let's see. So that's it. I've been working a whole lot of other stuff, but I just can't show it right now. And then the stuff that I did show you. So let's go on to upcoming. So for upcoming, I've got the three preemie hats I need to do for the month. So I've done number one. This is number two. And so I've got number three to make before the end of this month. So that'll be upcoming. I haven't picked one to see which one I'm going to be doing yet. But anyway, let's see. Also, I have the Mrs. Claus in the Rudolph set. Let me grab the box here. It is right there. Okay. So far, I've made Santa, Rudolph, Hermie, and on this side, I have made Clarice right there. And so the next one I'm going to be doing is Mrs. Claus there. And so I haven't started on her, but I'm going to. I'm starting looking around to get the yarn that I need for that out of my stash. So I should be starting on her, and you'll see at least part of her, I'm sure, next week. Okay, and then let's see. Oh, I got some happy mail, and so I made a video on that. It's a craft swap that I did with one of my viewers here on YouTube, and so I just filmed that, and so, oh my goodness, you have to check that out. She gave me such wonderful things, and so, like I said, I just filmed it. I will probably post it. I will probably wait to post it either Saturday or Sunday it'll come out, so that way I'll space my videos out a little bit, but I'll have the same outfit on because I just filmed it. Okay, and then let's see what else. Oh, somebody saw the flamingo bag that I did. This one right here. Right there. And somebody asked me, it's a friend of mine, and she loves llamas. And so she asked me if I could do a tote like that for her, but with a llama on it. And I said, sure, I can do that. And so I had to order, well, actually, I picked up some yarn. I went to Hobby Lobby, mask and everything, and I picked up the yarn for that. I had to get the gray, and I had to get some more white. But this is the chart that I'm going to be doing. It is the same chart that I used for the llama blanket. In fact, that's who I gave it to. He's a friend of mine. And so I'm going to use the same chart, but in this tote bag. So the llama blanket I did corner to corner. And so, of course, it came out large blanket size. And so I'm going to use the same chart, but I'm going to do single crochet graph gan type stitch where you follow the chart horizontally. And this is the chart that I'm going to be doing. And like I said, it was the same chart that I used for the blanket. So that's going to be really interesting the way this is going to turn out. And the stitch count is the same as the stitch count I did for the flamingo. And so the bag should be turn out the same. Okay, and so that is the chart, and like I said, I got the yarn today at Hobby Lobby. Now, actually, I ordered the gray yarn because I couldn't find it when I was trying to order it, like from Joann's online, they were out of stock, and they said they were out of stock in the store. Michael's was out of stock, and I was like, what's the deal with this gray yarn? Because I wanted this light gray yarn. And so I ordered some from Mary Maxim, but hasn't come in yet and hasn't shipped yet. And so I happened to go by, I was taking my son to work, and there's a Hobby Lobby that I drive by, and I saw that they were open. I didn't know if they had opened back up again or whatever, but they were open, and so I went in there with my mask on, and so I'll pop in a picture here of me with my mask and my bag of yarn that I got. I was sitting in the car and snapped a picture. So anyway, I got the yarn for that. So then I can get this tote started. And so the background is going to be gray like that. And then, and the only other yarn I got, it's in the other room. It's kind of boring. I mean, all I did was I got some Crafter's Secret, which is their yarn, the Hobby Lobby yarn, in this big jumbo thing of this light gray. And then I got two I Love This yarns in white, for his body, but that's it. And they didn't have the big jumbo in white. They had it in off-white, and it just didn't look, it looked a little bit dull against the gray. And so I got just the I Love This yarn in the white. It's a brighter white, and it's gonna look much better, I think. So anyway, and then the back side of that tote will be like I did this one, where I did the stripes, but I'll just pick out colors that I that are from the chart. This right here, this peach color, I've got some Red Heart Flamingo, I think will be perfect for that. And I think, in fact, I think I used that for the blanket. It won't take a whole lot of it, so I have that. And then I have some teal that I'm going to use for that part. And then I have some yellow. So anyway, that's what I'm going to be doing, and I'm anxious to get started with this now that I have the yarn for it. So I'll be getting started with that. And then, so that'll be for her, that she's wanting me to make it for her. She's commissioning me to make it, and so I wanted to go ahead and get started on it. She's a school nurse, and she has llamas in her office, llama decor, and so hopefully school will be starting back in the fall, and she'll have this tote bag that she'll be able to take stuff in to school with the llama on it. So anyway, I'm anxious to get started on that. So that is some of my many upcoming projects. And so on to the next section. I do want to do a couple of shout outs. I found two new people that I've subscribed to recently that I was wanting to let you know about. They have less than 50 subscribers, so go and check them out and welcome them to the Yarny community. The first one is Rabbit Craft Shack. I believe that's her channel, and I will link them below. I can't remember what her name is, but she said her nickname was Rabbit, and so that's why that's what it's called. And she has a she shack or she shed that she has her crafts stuff in, and she has several videos, and I've been watching them, and I'm hoping that she'll do a tour of her craft shack. And so check her out. She's got some great projects that she's been showing. And then also, I just found this person just like an hour or so ago, and I subscribed to her, and what I've seen of her videos, I am enjoying. And her name is Shelly Ray and Crochet. Okay, so her name's Shelly Ray. And so, like I said, she's got some good projects and things that she's making too. So check them, those two ladies out, and welcome them to the YouTube community. Okay, so that is all of that. Okay, so I did get a few things for Mother's Day. I got two pieces of Happy Mail through the mail, which were Mother's Day cards that I want to show you, and then what both of my sons gave me. But I think this video is getting a little bit long, so I think what I'm going to do is I'll film a little short little extra video for that. So and then I'll go ahead and release it maybe well, maybe this evening or tomorrow, but it'll be coming up quickly. So be looking for that. You can see what I got for Mother's Day. Okay, so let's go ahead and get ready to end the video today. I do want to thank, as always, thanks to my subscribers, my new subscribers that have just subscribed to me, and those that have been with me from the beginning. I'm coming up on the 3-year anniversary. In just a couple of weeks, I'll have 3 years of YouTube videos that I've put out. I can't believe it. It just seems like it's gone by so quickly. But if you haven't subscribed, then please do, and check out my, and follow me, my progress on all the mini projects that I'm always doing and starting and finishing and just sharing love of yarn with you. So if that is something that you enjoy watching, then please subscribe. Okay, and then I think that is it. I'm looking, I think. So I'm going to go ahead and end the video so then I can film the Mother's Day gift video. So thanks, guys, for watching. Have a great weekend, and we will see you in the next video. Bye.